बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ न्यू टॉपिक विच इज़ कॉमन फिब्युलर नर्व इंजरी। कॉमन फिब्युलर नर्व विच इज़ ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द कॉमन पेरोनियल नर्व इज़ द स्मॉलर टर्मिनल ब्रांच ऑफ द शियाटिक नर्व। द कॉमन फिब्युलर नर्व हैज़ द रूट वैल्यूज ऑफ L4, L5, S1 एंड S2। इट अराइजेज फ्रॉम द सुपीरियर एंगल ऑफ द पॉपलीटियल फोसा। सी हेयर इन दिस डायग्राम, दिस इज द सुपीरियर एंगल ऑफ द पॉपलीटियल फोसा। कॉमन पेरोनियल नर्व इज ओरिजिनेटिंग फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट एंड इट एक्सटेंड्स टू द लेटरल एंगल ऑफ द पॉपलीटियल फोसा अलॉन्ग द मीडियल बॉर्डर ऑफ द बाइसेप्स फेमरस मसल। दिस इज बाइसेप्स फेमरस मसल, ओके। इट देन वाइंड्स अराउंड द नेक ऑफ द फिब्युला टू पियर्स द फिब्युला longus muscle, which is also called as the peroneus longus muscle, and it divides into terminal branches which are deep peroneal nerve and the superficial peroneal nerve. Before its division, the common peroneal nerve gives off several branches in the popliteal fossa, but the common peroneal nerve supply only one muscle, which is the short head of the biceps femoris muscle. Otherwise, all other muscles are supplied by its branches, which are deep peroneal nerve and the superficial peroneal nerve. The deep peroneal nerve will supply the anterior compartment of the leg, and the superficial peroneal nerve will supply the lateral compartment of the leg. The common peroneal nerve is injured by the peripheral neuropathy and many other causes. The most common cause is the habitual leg crossing that compress the common fibular nerve as it cross around the neck of the fibula. See here in this diagram, the common fibular nerve is compressed here against the neck of the fibula because it is crossing and it is winding around the neck of the fibula. See here, this is the fracture of the neck of the fibula. Here also the common peroneal nerve will be damaged. What will be the effect of injury? Injuries to the peroneal nerve can cause numbness, tingling, pain, weakness, and a gait problem, which is called as foot drop. See here, foot drop. The branches of the common peroneal nerve, which is the deep peroneal nerve and the superficial peroneal nerve, will supply the anterior compartment of the leg and the lateral compartment of the leg respectively. The branches of the common peroneal nerve innervate and control the muscles in the leg that lift the ankle. See here, these muscles are lifting the ankle and they are pushing the toes upward. This is called as dorsiflexion. Okay, but if the deep peroneal nerve is damaged or the common peroneal nerve is damaged, so what will happen? These muscles will not be supplied and dorsiflexors will not act and there will be foot drop, just like in this diagram. There will be foot drop, okay? Ability to raise the foot is lost and the foot will drop. This is because of the common peroneal nerve injury.